to thank God because we know He's bigger than the devil. We begin to praise Him. So when we praise, we are praising God on account of our discernment of His presence. And you see, whenever you praise Him on account of your discernment of His presence, Scripture says He dwells and He inhabits in the places of His people. Because what you are doing is that you are making bold His presence. You are enlarging His cause within your situation. We praise God for who He is. So when I want to engage the hand of God, Scripture says that the children of Israel will come to the battlefront and they will begin to praise Him. For He is good and His name is exalted forever. And as they begin to sing it, and as they begin to praise, suddenly the hand of God will be seen in the battlefront. So you praise God and you praise through. In praises, the dimensions of God is downloaded upon the earth. You know how confused the devil will be when you have a problem and you are praising. Soon your praise will come to thanking. The distance between praise and thanksgiving is the answer. So when I'm praising and it answers, I begin to thank. As I'm praising and I make large His blessing, He comes and brings on my request. And He begins to bring answers to my request. And I begin to thank Him individually for my request. Because He ceases to be a request, it becomes an answer. Scripture said that Paul and Silas locked up in the dungeon of darkness. Scripture said that they prayed, they praised, they sang. And while they were doing that, the Holy Ghost came down and inhabited their praise, and there was breakthrough for them. The children of Israel will come to God to the battlefront. Jericho was standing before them. It was a great mountain, it was a great wall, keeping them from advancing. And they looked upon that wall, and the instruction came from the great wall. And they began to walk around. For 7 days they were walking around, prepared with their cymbals. They walked around. For 7 days they kept on walking around, prepared with their tambourine. And for 7 days they kept on walking around. And the most potent weapon in your praise is your words. And as they were walking around, on the 7th day, Scripture says they lifted up their voice and they began to shout and they began to give praise to the great I Am. And as they did that, the wall came crumbling down. The wall of Jericho came down because men praised God in the midst of their problems. Some persons will call it to praise God. Because when you praise, it's a passage. Praise creates for you a free route. You are going through that route to meet the answer to your prayers. Through praise, you are involving God in your matter. You are partnering with Him, saying to Him that this mountain is too small. It's just too small for the one that I carry. And you are in praise, you are ignoring the mountain and exalting the God yourself. And when you exalt Him, the mountain suddenly, you see, look at how it happens. As you are praising God, you start growing. As you are praising God in the spirit realm, you are becoming like Him. As you are praising God, you are more conscious of Him. As you are praising God, your problem and the situations of life begins to look small. The level of the fool will get him. Because he knows not how to get to the city. So the fool knows the city.